Most photo editing applications have the ability to adjust image levels, and Capture One Pro 7 is no exception. The Levels tool can be found by default in the Exposure tool tab. The Levels tool is capable of adjusting contrast, brightness, and tonal range. To see the effect, it's useful to observe the histogram as well. The Levels tool has three adjustments: black point, white point, and midtones. The position of these sliders redefines the input levels so they are mapped to the output levels shown at the top of the Levels tool. These are 0 and 255 by default. If we examine a particularly flat image, it is easy to see the effect of the Levels tool. This image has very little or no information at either end of the histogram. Most images look best if we can utilize the full range of tones from 0 to 255. By moving the level sliders towards the histogram, we can adopt the best input level setting for a given image. It may be helpful to turn on exposure warnings to make sure we do not clip any subtle highlights or shadows. Then we can accurately set the relevant points. Use the midtone slider to brighten or darken the midtones. Just by these few simple adjustments, we've made a dramatic improvement to the image. If you would like to adjust the final output values, move the output sliders at the top of the histogram in a little. This will limit the maximum highlight value and minimum shadow value. As an alternative to moving the sliders, both shadow and highlight values can be set with their respective pickers. Use these to choose the points on the image which you want to be the maximum highlight and the minimum shadow. Capture One will then set the levels to match the values found in the Exposure tab in the Capture One Preferences. Take care in using this method as you are more likely to clip the highlights or shadows. The red, green and blue color channels can be adjusted individually by clicking on the respective tabs. Adjusting the channels individually may adversely affect the color balance, so only do this if intentional color shifts are desired. Once the levels are set, the curve tool enables you to remap the area within the shadow and highlight limits, the result being the ability to make precise changes in tone and contrast. Note that the levels are also shown over the curve. By moving the cursor anywhere over the image, we can recognize the location of a tone represented by a vertical line underneath the curve. To set a point on the curve, use the Pick Curve Point Picker in the Curve tool. Click anywhere in the image. Adjust the point on the curve to remap the input value to a new output value. These values are shown underneath the curve. Add further points in the same way, or simply click on the curve to add a new point. To remove a selected point, simply hit the Delete or Backspace key. The curves can also have individual channel adjustments, much like levels. The same earlier warning also applies using the Curves tool regarding color adjustments.